Hey folks, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS with some more fire-related MOCs to throw into my city. So I've got basically two vehicles here with some folks to go with them. This is a hazmat crew truck, or hazmat response truck, and this is a fire investigator's truck. So I'll just go ahead and look at the investigator's truck first. Small, pretty basic, simple looking from the outside. Didn't really put any effort into making the outside look special or unique or anything, and just wanted to make a really small van that had the look of a commercial, like a light commercial kind of vehicle, and experimented again, like I've continued to do, just experimenting with some slightly different techniques for putting together vehicles to get them to look different, you know, different from what's currently the norm, from what Lego gives us. Didn't even bother putting in a detailed interior for this one, because I probably won't ever put a guy in, but I might add in at least the steering wheel. I kind of forgot about the steering wheel, but seat doesn't matter so much. This is the guy, the fire investigator. He basically goes into the scene of a fire after the fire has been put out, and he goes around to see if he can figure out what caused the fire, whether it was arson or an electrical issue or, you know, some other sort of accident or something. And he's got a tablet computer that he's carrying with him. But the most important thing here, well, first off, I just wanted to have another small vehicle for my fire crew, something that wasn't a firefighting vehicle, you know, because there are a lot of non-firefighting vehicles in real life that are associated with fire departments. But the main thing here was at the back, he does have the ability to get in there, and there's stuff inside. So this is a little field kit, or part of his field kit. He has a couple of mixing jars. Maybe one of those would have some chemicals for testing. Got a syringe for picking up some samples, and a drill for drilling into things. Maybe taking some core samples of some wood, see how quickly it burned, how deep it burned, you know, find out the depth of ash or something, I don't know. The chemical stuff would be for detecting the presence of accelerants and things like that. And he's got obviously a magnifying glass, and then he's got some, you know, notepad and pieces of paper and stuff. On the inside of this thing, there's some more stuff, and I did not make the roof easy to remove, and I don't care because I didn't want to make it any taller than it is, so I'm perfectly happy with how this is designed. And inside there are a couple of cones that he can put out, little traffic cones that he can put out when he stops at a scene. There's a saw for getting through heavier stuff, and he also has a tool chest that he can pull out and use as needed. So oopsie, I just broke the whole thing apart. It is completely ruined. That's it. It's done. It's done for. Oh well, it was nice while it lasted. Ah, look at that. It's all back together. Okay. I'll just throw this back in there, and that pretty much does it for this pair here. And then let's move on to the hazmat response truck. A little bit bigger, a little bit different. Kept adding to this one, adding, and did get the look that I was going for with it. I'm happy to break free of the red just for this one. I've seen a lot of hazmat response vehicles that don't use the core color scheme of that particular fire department. And yeah, pretty happy with the look of this one from the outside. You know, it looks kind of proper to me. And I got a slightly different type of truck there with a slightly longer nose, a little bit of older style with the use of slopes instead of the rounded slopes. Inside this would carry two people back here. I actually have seats in there, but I haven't put in any other detail. And then there'd be equipment. You can see there's lots of places to put equipment, and there's of course a driver would go up front. And I'll show you the people in a second, or I'll show them again. But up here, this top part, probably put too much time into this and took up too much space for it. But I wanted to have, oopsie, those are a little bit tight. I wanted to have something that could change up on top. And as I built stuff, it ended up coming with this kind of clamshell design, and that opens up, and then this would come up like this and stops right there. goes level, and then this comes up, and the intent here is to have sort of an eye in the sky. It's a spectroscopic camera that would be able to basically see chemicals in the air by analyzing how they bend light. And that's basically what that's intended to be. So they kind of have a way of looking ahead and finding chemical clouds before they walk into them, and maybe doing a little bit of analysis. So, you know, just a little something different. I don't know if they have any such thing in real life, but I kind of like the story behind it. It seems potentially plausible, maybe if only in a science fiction sort of way, but yeah, gives just another thing to do with this vehicle. Gives it a little ability to change up a little bit, and gives it some reason to have some extra stuff on top. And then the people that go with this one are, this is the driver, and he'd be the supervisor, the incident supervisor. So you can see he's staying back from a distance and keeping track of what's going on from a safe distance away. From less of a safe distance away, definitely, is this guy. And here I've used a similar face expression to the official hazmat guy, but I've actually swapped in the skydiver face because I had way too many skydivers, so I used that one here. Extra set of goggles on the inside there, and used an actual fire uniform, top and bottom. He's got some sort of chemical sensor here, and I just, again, used a different color just to not always color coordinate everything, because not everything in real life is color coordinated. So some kind of sensor, and he's got a canary with him just as a backup. So if the canary starts to pass out or dies, then he knows that stuff is getting really, really serious, and he'll probably run away because he looks really, really scared of everything, even though this is his job and this is what he's trained to do. And then here's another of the same type of guy with the same exact expression, and he's just got some sort of really long prod for prodding at stuff from a distance. Because again, they're always just scared of the stuff that they're walking into, and don't know how dangerous it's gonna be. So that's basically what they do. They stand off. I don't know what they actually do in this Lego world, but there they are, and there are their vehicles. And this guy's a little bit more serious and professional. And that's it. That's it for this video. And just look at a couple more mocks, and I've got more mocks to come, so stay tuned for those, as well as, of course, reviews. And subscribe if you haven't already, if you want to see more videos from me. If you don't want to see more videos from me, then don't subscribe and don't watch the videos. It's no problem. No problem at all, and no offense taken. However, if you do want to see all of my updates as quickly as they come out, including updates that show up before they show up on YouTube, be sure to follow JANGBRiCKS.com, and I'll see you there.